Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the RSR Video Email Bag Show. Now here's the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing, your host, Bad Brad Berkwit. Forget about it.
The great Roy Orbison, crying. You tell me a better voice than that. I mean, he sang all the way up here. Forget about it. Let me give you a little bit more of the late, great Roy Orbison to bring us back from a summer break.
And start me crying. I thought that I was over you, but it's true.
Freaking voice, forget about it. Hey folks, we're back. We took a brief, I wouldn't say brief, about a month and a half hiatus from doing the show. But we're back, and I got questions from here to Kalamazoo, forget about it, that I got to answer. But hey, this is going to be the first one, and I'm going to answer your questions as I always do. Now, before we get into your questions, we have a contest. The 600th subscriber to the RSR YouTube channel will get this book, Running with the Champ, My 40-Year Friendship with Muhammad Ali. You will win this great book, which I reviewed on the RSR YouTube channel a couple months ago. And how do you win it? Be the 600th subscriber to the RSR YouTube channel and just hit that button, subscribe. Okay, and that's all you gotta do to enter the contest. You will get this book, we'll pay for postage and handling to your locations, and it is a great, great book. Now, without further ado, forget about it. Let's get into your questions. First question is, Bad Brad, where have you been, mate? I've been having RSR Video Email Bag Show withdrawals with the GGG versus Brook fight coming up next month. How do you see this fight going? Cheers, Aussie Jack from Brisbane, Australia. Aussie Jack, you're back. Forget about it. It's been a while since you sent a question there, pal. Okay, well, first of all, let's talk about the GGG versus Kell Brook fight. First of all, do I think it's a mismatch, like a lot of people are saying? Yes and no. Kell Brook is a very talented, much smaller fighter, even though I know he did the 30-day weigh-in, unofficial weigh-in, or whatever you call it. It was like 170 pounds. Forget about it, but he's a welterweight moving up to middleweight, so you got two weight classes there. Has it been done before? Sure, it's been done before. But do I think he has a chance against Triple G? Well, you know what? I'm going to be fair to Kell Brook. First of all, he's got big cojones to take this match because Canelo catchweight Alvarez, if you're watching the show, Esto Uno, you know, Ballos. Okay, you don't want to fight him for whatever freaking reason. And Oscar, I'm very disappointed in you, De La Hoya. Okay, you need to make that fight. But hey, whatever. So Kell Brook steps up. So I give him props there. Does he have a chance to win? Absolutely. Absolutely. Do I see him winning is the question. No, I don't. How do I see this fight going? Wait for a drum roll. I see Triple G taking Kell Brook out between 6 and 8. Between the 6th and 8th round. Now, with that said, as I always tell you folks, when I pick a fighter on record, when I don't go on record, I usually am 98% correct. But when I go on record, for some reason, that ratio goes down. Forget about it. So bet the house on Kell Brook. But 6 to 8, Gennady Golovkin, with some moments in there when Kell Brook does a couple things with them. But I think 6 to 8, he knocks Kell Brook out. But hey, if Kell Brook wins, it's a hell of a win on his resume, and that will put him in the stratosphere for pay-per-view fights from here on out, in my opinion, okay? So there you have it, Aussie Jack. Next question. Hey, Bad Brad, why is the Olympic boxing team not that great anymore? We used to dominate that event. Thanks, Mark G. from South Vacherie, Louisiana. Well, Mark G., you're a first-time writer, pal, but I know that you're in RSR form. Okay, let me answer your question. Why is the Olympic boxing teams not as good? Well, first of all, we had magical teams in 76 and in 84, especially 76, but 84 as well. But in my opinion, and you'll have probably other people say agree with me and elaborate even more, but to me, in fairness to the amateur fighters today, first of all, let me say this before I answer that part. I am so disgusted with the freaking Rio Olympics boxing portion and what the AIBA, I think it's called, has done. First of all, the judges are mamelukes. Forget about it. Horrible scoring. They screwed Gary Antoine Russell. They screwed that young man. Split decision for the other guy. Bafungu to the judges. And for the Irish kid that shot him the finger to judges, good for you, kid, because they suck. It's reminiscent of how they screwed Roy Jones over in 1988. Now, why do I think that the teams aren't as great? Well, first of all, in fairness to the amateur fighters, today there's not as many venues for these kids to fight. Like, even in my day, I was an amateur for 3 years from 80 to 83. You had many, many, many more venues. A lot more amateur boxing going on. So I think that hurts them, okay? And then they go to the Olympics, and they got this bullshit this year with the pros being in there, even though these pros got their ass kicked, from what I understand, but it's not right, okay? I can live with the headgear coming off, but all the other crap, the AIBA or whatever it's called, it's done, it's bullshit. I feel it's because they don't have as many venues to hone their skills, okay? And I'm sure there's other reasons, too. And then, again, you know, the fighters of yesteryear, even in the pros, are better than most of the fighters today, which is just fact. They trained harder, 15-round championship fights. It was just a different time. But we still have great fighters today. So that's my thoughts on why the amateur fighters are not as good today. But we do still have some damn good ones, let's be fair. All right, folks, so on that note, we're going to take a short commercial break. Hey, folks, this is Bad Brad Berkwick, the host of the RSR Video Email Bag Show. Forget about it. And I want to talk to you about an exciting opportunity to advertise or sponsor on my show. If you're interested, send serious business inquiries to ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Again, that's ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Forget about it.
Excuse me?
What?
Aren't we supposed to be doing a shoot for your book ad?
Yeah, but I'm reading right now. I'm reading an interview in my book with James Quartillis. And I tell you what, I didn't realize I did a heck of an interview.
And?
And I guess we do need to do this book ad.
Yeah.
Hey, folks, here's the book. Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime by the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Me. Forget about it. All right, there it is on the back. Okay, and on the front. Now, how do you order this book? You go to authorhouse.com and you'll pick it up wholesale. You'll save a few fazools, forget about it. But if you want to go to Amazon or Barnes & Noble, you can do that too. You're just going to pay retail that way. Now, for all the folks that ask me, yes, I will take this book here if you mail it to me and cover postage and handling to Tulsa and to wherever you live in the world. I will personally autograph your book. Again, Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime. Bye. The man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it. Bad Brad out. All right, folks. We're back from summer hiatus. And I am, if you forgot, the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Bad Brad Berkwit. And this is the RSR Video Email Bag Show. Now, again, the 600 subscribers to the RSR YouTube channel will win this fantastic book. Running with the Champ, that's Muhammad Ali. My 40-year friendship with Muhammad Ali. All you gotta do is hit that button and subscribe. Leave comments on the RSRU channel, RSR YouTube channel. I'll get it out. Leave comments if you want. Vote it up, vote it down, whatever you want to do. This is America. Forget about it. All right, let's get into the rest of the questions for this show. Next question. Bad Brad, big fan of yours. First time writing in. I see Grandpa Roy Jones for the sumo wrestler. Oh, shit. And Rodney Moore last weekend and went 10 with a guy who 10 years ago, he would have taken him out in two. What is Roy's problem? He is one of the greatest. And though I think he goes into the International Boxing Hall of Fame first time up, this is embarrassing to say the least. Are you in the camp that says let him fight, he has the right? What do you think? Signed, John A. from Alexandria, Virginia. Well, John A., forget about it. Alexandria, Virginia, pal. That's where I lived before I moved out here to be with Debbie in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Forget about it. Okay, first of all, I am not in a camp that says, let him fight. He's got every right to. Which he does. But I'm not in that camp. He's 47, and he's an old 47 years old. He's third person Roy Jones. You know, on HBO when he talks in third person. Roy, I hate that shit that you do on HBO. Drives me freaking bananas. Forget about it. But no, I'm not in the camp that says he should be able to fight. He's been knocked out several times. Devastating knockouts. I've said it, and I will say it again. No commission, and shame on the Florida commission, because he fought in Pensacola, for giving him a boxing license. I'm not sure why. I think it's ego. Maybe a little bit of money, but he's got that HBO deal. I don't know what he's got in his bank account. Honestly, I don't really give a shit what he has or what he doesn't have. Because if he blew it, that's his fault. I don't have pity on people that blow their wealth. Okay? That's on you. You can blame everybody else ripped you off, but you allow it. But whatever. No, he should not be able to fight again. Yes, I agree with you. He goes in the Hall of Fame, International Boxing Hall of Fame. First time ballot. Absolutely. In his day, he was... a bad mamma jamma, but that was a long time ago. He should have retired after he fought Antonio Tarver the first time and looked bad when he lost that weight after he won the WBA heavyweight title against John Ruiz. He's embarrassing himself. He's hurting his legacy to an extent, but he cemented it. He has cemented his legacy. However, he's embarrassing himself and the sport of boxing because he should not be fighting. He looked horrible. He played with the guy who did look like, good analogy, looked like a sumo wrestler. All right, so there's the answer to your question, John A. from Alexandria, Virginia, my old stomping grounds. All right, folks, the last question of this summer RSR video email bag show. Forget about it. Bad Brad. Oh, how I miss you, my forget about it man. Oh, I already know who this is, folks. It's been like forever since you did your last show. Where are you? Remember, never fear, your Meshuggah the Jew is near. Dad sends his regards. I wanted to ask you, what did you think of heavyweight Ron Lyle? I think up until the stoppage, and a bad one at that, he was beating Muhammad Ali in their heavyweight title fight. Hugs and kisses, your blue Jew, Janet from the Bronx. Yo, Janet, my blue Jew. Kisses to you, darling, and best to your father. Forget about it. First of all, God rest his soul, we lost Ron Lyle a couple years ago. He's actually one of the interviews in my book, Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime. He was a bad dude in his day. He could punch with the best of them. And I do agree with you. I think he was beating Muhammad Ali. I think it was a bad stoppage. I think it was in the 11th round that he stopped him. Muhammad Ali, the referee, stopped the fight. But he was a great fighter. He had some good, solid wins. And I'll tell you what, if Ron was competing today, heavyweight champion of the world, undisputed, he'd clean out the freaking division, in my opinion, of course, like it is. All right, my blue Jew, you're going to be the last one of this show. Forget about it. All right, folks, I hope you enjoyed our first show back after a long hiatus. Okay, remember, I am the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing, Bad Brad Berkwood. And that is another RSR video email bag show in the can. Forget about it. And as Frank Sinatra sang, wait for it, because it's been a minute, so eloquently, so long ago, the best is yet to come. Bad Brad out.